looking for trouble, you came to the right place. If you're looking for trouble, just look right in my face. I was born standing up and talking back. My daddy was a green-eyed mountain jack.
Funny thing about a heat wave, you'll be cruising along, cool as can be, and then, when you're not looking, it hits you like a blast furnace. So you sweat, and you wait, and just when you think it's gonna blow over, it gets even worse. People can be that way. Dallas Winston was. So's Tim Shepard. They can't help it. It's just the way they are.
Hey, Cherry.
Hi, Pony Boy. I didn't see you.
Oh, God, I've got biology in 10 minutes. Hey, you got your wheels outside?
Actually, I've got a couple of stops I have to make. I tell you what, I'll cover for you with Mr. George.
Well, how now, brown cow? What have we here?
Hey, Cherry. I thought you and I were going cruising after school. Or are you slumming with the lowlifes now?
She's with you, isn't she?
That's funny. You know, for a little runt, you got a big mouth. A fella can get hurt with a big mouth.
Okay, Greg, I'm real impressed. You're a real he-man, okay? Look, I've got a history exam. Can we go, please?
You know, here I thought you're shopping for hairspray. Turns out you go for the greasy kid stuff.
Cut it out!
Get up! Looks like you're running a little light on the old salad oil.
Greg.
You know what they say, sport? Little dabble, do you?
That's not what I call too neighborly, sport.
Hi, Cherry.
Well, now, what do you say? What do you know, Pony Boy?
Huh? Same old, same old. Mr. Harper says there's a good article in American Digest.
Oh, yeah? Well, I like my stories condensed. How about you? You like your stories condensed? Huh? You know, as in crammed. I'm sorry, Greg.
All right, hey. Everybody out.
Yes. Let me out, Greg.
So the stove, she's banging at the window, begging Greg to say sorry.
Oh, please, please, let me out of here.
You know, you're real smart. You're out of the joint 4 hours, and you're already in trouble.
Hey, Tim looks out for his own. Still number one around here.
Yeah, that's right.
That's right.
Free game, kiddo.
Whoa, hey, Tim.
You always do that to us, Tim. Beat stamping license plates.
Man.
So where are you going to be staying? Got a berth at your mom's?
Just got out of one jail. Don't need to go to another. Figure I'll give your floor the honor.
We sort of got the welfare lady breathing down our necks. Might be able to get you a job at the building I'm doing.
Grunt work, man, not my line.
Yeah, well, the pro board might sit a little different.
Oh, come on, guys. Oh, shoot.
Hey,
Get out of here. Plenty of time for work, Buck. Sea's full of fish.
Yeah, well, not in your muddy creek. As far as this town's concerned, you're just a set of stripes with a number across the back.
So, Tim, is it true what they say about the joint being tough and all? That's just a bunch of bull.
Not too rough, man. To blade at your throat every day is all.
That's cool.
Enough of this show now. How about you itching the tangle?
How about you, Susie Q? You itching the tangle, baby?
Okay, Soda, the party's over.
Shoot, Buck.
It's all right, Soda Pop, this one's on me. Fill her up, ma'am. Looks like a high test lady to me.
So you're working here now?
Only choice customers. You gotta be a prom queen with a saddle-sitting shotgun.
The jail hasn't changed you much.
Wrong. I'm more dangerous than ever now. Especially around phone booths. What do you got, one of them tame ponies takes the trail slow and easy?
Actually, he's a quarter horse. He's meaner than mean and twice as wild.
Wow. Sounds too much for you.
I can handle it. Just takes a little patience.
And the right touch. Figure you have that?
So you back in town for good?
Or bad. Depends on the wind.
Makes sense. Why can't Tim stay?
Look, we've been through this 10 times before.
We've got room to spare.
Make it 11. You know how the welfare lady operates. How's it gonna look?
Like we're taking up for a friend, doing the right thing.
Like he did for me today.
What do you got against Tim? You're always down on him.
Hey, my number one lookout, your belly, which happens to be full.
So what's he gonna cost? An extra box of cornflakes?
Damn straight. I offered him a job. He thinks he's too good for it.
Jerry, he's a stand-up guy.
Always was and always will be. He even went to jail for us.
Hey, nobody asked him to put a gun to a cop's head. And for what? Ever since they've been on our tails. Look, Tim and me, we go back a ways. And it's not like I don't care.
He's one of us. We owe him.
Hello, Mom.
Started up your car while you was gone. Shame to let that battery to die.
Appreciate it. Sure is hot out.
Damn parasites. This time of year, they come out all over.
Remember how Pa always used to fall down trying to get those cobwebs?
When you're drunk, falling comes natural.
Here, let me give you a hand with that.
Don't need no hands! A long time ago, how to get by on my own. Passing through, are you?
No. Figure I'd give the straight life a whirl. Really, Mom. I'm home for good now. So I think I'll go lay out on the old sofa.
I wouldn't go in there.
If there's any cobwebs, I'll take care of you.
Already taken care of. Your old sofa's gone.
You can turn off the water now, Mom. Your hands are clean.
I Timbo, missing your choir practice, boy.
In the joint, you never squelch a shot.
Yeah? Well, I never played against myself in the joint. Where you boys hold up?
South Street Hotel.
Enjoying the good life, are you?
Well, now things changed while we was inside, Timbo. Pack of weeds is up. Dime won't even buy you a nickel.
Sounds like y'all need a job.
Yeah, we got one in mind. But with the water and power?
One with a fat payroll truck?
Yeah, we cased it out real good. It's a cherry deal, just like you said, Tim.
Yeah, well, a man says a lot of things behind bars. Table's all yours, boys.
What's your problem, man? You think you're better than us?
Not better, just smarter.
Oh, no, that's pretty big talk for a boy been out a day. Try a couple months, see how you're surviving.
My mind's all made up. I ain't going back in that joint.
You still in the joint, Timbo. You just don't know it yet.
Whatever you say, man. If you boys will excuse me.
I got me a couple of lonely ladies. Just dying for my company.
Yeah, well, sooner or later, you're gonna come a-running to us.
Y'all to be careful. There's a little something going on in Vietnam. There's a war in the jungle. You never know what you'll find or what'll find you in Nam or on the street. So be careful. It's midnight.
Looking for trouble, you came to the right place. If you're looking for trouble.
Evening, Shepard.
Evening, Officer Jarrett.
Parole board know you're loafing by the road?
Who's loafing? Hey, I'm all rehabilitated. Thinking about wearing me a tie. You boys accepting applications?
You got yourself a real king-sized attitude, don't you?
Well, let me tell you something, punk. Put a gun to my partner's head. Now it's payback time. You drive 1 mile over the speed limit, you so much as spit in the streets. Yeah. I'm coming to look for you. The same gun's gonna be pointed your way. The hammer's cocked, boy. It's waiting on you. No parking, Shepard.
Never looked for trouble. I never ran. I don't take no orders. No kind of man.
So we're in my caddy, right? Roy Orbison's on the box. Got my shirt off. Boom, just spots my scar.
What scar?
This one here. Got it in the laundry first week at the camp.
Yes, sir, then what'd she do?
Knocked her for a loop, man. Thought she'd damn near open my stitches.
So then what happened?
Elvis came on the radio.
Oh, shit, man, that never happens to me. One more bacon, Tim?
Only if it's crispy. Point is, you can't sit in your dust waiting for these things to happen. You can quote me on that, Hemingway.
Shoot, that's Steve. I gotta go. Buckles, skin me alive if I'm late again.
Hey, man,
Don't ever let them see you sweat. Got that? Because when you do, they walk all over you.
You're right, man.
What time, man? What's Dick and Terry so long in the shower? Supposed to meet his boss at 8 o'clock.
He's real particular about his ankles. Scrubs them real hard. So what about him?
His ankles?
Your drawings. When am I going to get to see him?
As soon as you're done with that story you're writing. I mean, I'm the hero. I figure I got me a claim.
Oh, there's still a lot of chapters left to write.
Don't be so sure, Pony Boy. You know what they say, man. Good die young. Okay. You laugh, you die. Careful now.
Those palm trees?
Those Mexican palm trees. A place called Baja, California. In the joint, man, that's all this old geezer talked about. Said you could sit on the beach. Said pineapple drinks with little umbrellas in them. $20,000, he said, and you could live like a king for the rest of your life.
Well, for starters, it wouldn't help if you get a job, okay? Chop, chop, let's move.
What I like about you, Jerry, always looking out for me. You got your fancy kid, and I got mine.
And you're dropping half your 10 pennies on the floor.
Mr. Beto, about the fellow I mentioned, Martinez, Team Shepherd.
Martinez, I want the edge of those joists up, not down. So you're the con, huh?
Ex-con. Society and me are paid up now.
Yeah, first time in the big house.
Not if you count Juvie Hall.
Benson, you drop one more of those nails, it's coming out of your salary.
Juvie Hall, huh? That's cookies and milk next to the big house.
Mr. Beto is a good man. I've worked with him before.
You know what a lollycollum is?
Pulls up an I-beam.
Anchor bolt?
Bolts down the frame. What is this, 20 questions?
I don't know, Curtis. My sister-in-law has been on me to put her boy working after school.
Well, Mr. Better, I'm more than willing to vouch for it.
Vouch? Look, I don't need no voucher, especially from you, Curtis. Mr. Better, the next time you're considering hiring an ex-con, make sure you look her in the eye, okay? Good work there, Benson. Keep it up.
Hey, Mickey, we need another load of 3A's fly.
How'd you do on your essay?
I could have done worse. But you got an A, didn't you?
A minus. Mr. France said my paper reeked of hair tonic.
Listen, Pony Boy, about the other day, I feel terrible.
Hey, forget it. That's old news.
It's just when I'm with the other kids, it's like I'm a different person.
It's the way things are. Everybody's trying to be what they're not. That Tim Shepherd boy, he was something else, wasn't he?
You like him, don't you?
You bet I do.
I don't know. He's kind of scary. When he looks at you, it's like a wild animal.
Sometimes you gotta see past all that, the pose and all. Tim, he's as hurt and lonely as the rest of us. Just shows it less.
Fill your tank, lady, with no pumps.
Oh, no, I just,
Yeah, I saw your car.
See, I parked it over there. I thought maybe we could...
Thought what?
I thought maybe we could...
Thought maybe you could help me out with my blue jeans?
You know, you have an incredible talent for making people feel very uncomfortable.
Better watch that pretty little dress of yours. Might get it all dirty.
This whole thing? My daddy bought it for me for the country club barbecue.
Must have missed that one.
Yeah, well, he loves to show me off. Treats me like a Barbie doll. I saw you back there a few minutes ago. Would you do quit your job?
What job?
In the diner. Give the man his apron back.
Oh, you must have got me mixed up with someone else. I don't wear aprons.
What I mean is, if you need a job, they're looking for somebody over at the stables.
Yeah? Doing what?
Oh, you know, cleaning out the stalls, picking up. Look, maybe I better go.
No. I mean, look, darling, what's your hurry? You came over here pecking for something, right? Got your dress all dirty. Maybe we can smudge it up a little more, you and me.
Get your hands off. Look, I was just trying to help.
Oh, I need help, darling. All us greasers do. Take us on, wash us off. It's just that easy, ain't it? Go on, Daddy's waiting.
Mr. Beto, didn't you ever need a break? Con just one push start to get your life going?
Well, I'm running a business here, kid, not a charity.
Look, it was a courtesy. I even told you about Tim. I could have hired him, and you wouldn't have known the difference.
Curtis, I was taking a chance when I hired you.
Are you not satisfied with the work I'm doing?
Can I say that? I am not saying that.
I bid you low. I give you quality work on schedule as contract.
And you're doing a great job. Just don't rock the boat. Now, if that's all, I got to get going, okay?
Mr. Beto, before I was asking you for a favor, now I'm telling you what I got to have.
Curtis, what's the Shepherd kid got on you anyway?
He's my friend, and what I owe him is my affair.
Something wrong, soda pop?
Yes, something's wrong. My paycheck's wrong.
Not the way I see it. You and Steve were late last week.
What, all of a lousy 40 minutes?
Well, that didn't include the lousy hour you spent on Tim Shepherd's car.
Look, come on, we'll make it up next week. Buck. The man just got out a couple days ago. He needs his wheels.
Oh, maybe he does, but not on my time.
Your time? Since when do you own a clock?
Kid, would you take a gander at that piece of paper you're holding in your hand? That's my John Henry on there.
Look, come tomorrow. We'll be in here 10 minutes early, okay? Now, come on. Speak for yourself. The way I see it, this man here owes me $8.70. Now, either I get what's coming to me, or...
What?
So I'm begging and pleading, right? Then out of nowhere, Beto gives in. He says Tim starts the day after tomorrow. I couldn't believe my ears.
Man, wish I'd seen that.
Well, I'm glad you didn't. It ain't a pretty sight seeing a grown man scraping his knees. You got that peanut butter coupon?
Dang. I think it's true what Tim says.
It's canned beans, not peanut butter.
You mean about Mexico being a paradise and all?
Kid, for us, paradise is right here in these coupons.
Yeah, but umbrellas and pineapples can't arrest a man for dreaming.
Dreaming, yeah, I remember doing that once. Hey, it's after 9. Don't you know to call when you're gonna be late?
Don't you start on me now, Derry. I'm not in the mood.
Why? What happened?
What happened? I quit my job, that's what happened. Like Tim says, give them an inch, they wanna walk all over you.
Yes, sir, Mr. Bosser, man.
What the hell are you doing here?
Picking up some money from Tim.
For what?
Souping up his caddy.
I thought you had an interview down at the Dairy Queen.
So what?
So what? How are you gonna get a job full of grease?
Get off my back, Derry. It's only chump change anyway.
That Beto's been on my back for 2 days. Fix it up, he's gonna burn a hole in it.
Buck tells me you've been playing pool with a couple of hard dogs.
Yeah, well, I'm a friendly kind of guy.
Buck pegs him for prison scum.
You mean like me? Pipe fitters out of the joint. Just look at them display their talents is all.
I just bet they are.
You wouldn't be losing faith in me now, would you, Derry?
Curtis! You're gonna get
these shingles out of my carpenter's way, or am I going to plow them over?
Ma'am, will you listen to that windbag?
Just 2 cents.
You just what? Quit your job like my brother?
I knew it. I saw this coming a mile away.
Look, all I know is Soda Sullen giving me all this lip.
You saying that's my doing?
He thinks you're royalty, man. Like everybody owes you.
Curtis! Come on!
Not everybody, Derry. Just some.
I'm serious, Cherry. I mean, it's more than just your cheerleading splits. You know what it is?
No, but I'm sure you're going to tell me.
It's the way you walk. You know, your head held up high, your hair blowing in the wind. You know, the way you sashay, I tell you, it makes Scott feel proud to stand next to you. Believe me, I don't say that to too many girls. Come on. It's true, I don't.
Would you excuse me?
Yeah, sure.
The other day, too.
About what?
Not being judged and all. About people not being able to see past the outside. That's a tough way to get by.
Well, life's drag, ain't it?
What do you say we dish in?
Come again?
We can scoot out the back door and nobody'd be the wiser.
Oh, I see. Just drop Grant like he never existed.
You can't stand him.
Like fudge, you don't know that.
But you can't, right?
This is ridiculous. I'm not gonna discuss my feelings in a public bathroom.
The door's right there.
Open up! Police! You're in the wrong room, boy.
I'm sorry, Officer Jarrett. I must have forgotten my reading glasses.
Get out of here. Now. Uh-oh. Not that way, boy. You use the back door.
I think you ought to go back to Bucks.
No way.
Come on, man, just tell him you're sorry.
About what? It's his doing, not mine.
Yeah, but Derry says we all have to do a little bit of eat and crow.
Yeah, Derry would know a lot about that. I mean, what has it got him? Nothing but a big dead end.
Come on, man, it's not so bad.
Maybe not for you, Pony. You got a gift. You're a writer. What do I got? Nothing. Just another greaser going nowhere.
You don't mean that, man. Tell me you don't mean that or I won't go to sleep.
Go to sleep, Pony Boy.
So, Ma, like I'm telling you, they think I'm this top-notch roofer. I mean, Derry really loves my work.
Hand me that pillowcase.
And my boss, he's this real great guy. He's even talking about making me foreman.
Uh-huh.
You know what else, Mom? There's this great girl I've been seeing. Social girl, real high society. Even threw over her fancy boyfriend for me, too.
Look at that sheet. Bleach ain't worth a damn. What's this?
It's a birthday present.
That was 3 months back.
Well, I was a little indisposed. It's money I earned, Mama. A week's worth. It's clean.
I don't want your money.
But I earned it. It's for you.
What do you think? You could come back here and buy me off.
Ma, you got the wrong idea. I'm not trying to buy you off.
Daddy, you go tomcat and months on end, come back here, tail between his legs, a bottle of cheap perfume in his hands.
I'll wrap it for you. I'll put it in your sewing
box. Thinking I'm some kind of $2 slut he could buy off?
It'll be there for you when you need it, Ma.
Much as he cared, much as he ever cared.
Ma, you gotta take this money. It's for you. I earned it.
Get out and take your dirty money with you. You're no damn good. You never was. You're just like your father.
My wallet's gone.
Are you sure?
No, I'm kidding. Yeah, I'm sure. You know, while I was up on top, you were the only one down here.
Something on your mind, friend. Spit it out.
All right. I've been here 2 weeks. I don't have to worry about where my wallet is. You show up, and suddenly it's missing.
What's the problem?
There's no problem. It's a little misunderstanding.
So you say. I say it's stole. And the only one near it was this ex-con.
So what? Want to check my pockets? Is that it?
Huh? How about you, Mr. Beto, huh? You got a big bug up your butt! Want to look at my car? Is that it?
Can you believe this, man?
Just back off.
No! I'm sick of being blamed for things I didn't do. I stand accused here, right? Don't I?
Mr. Beto here thinks that I'm guilty.
Don't you, Mr. Beto? Come on!
Oh, man. I don't need this. I don't need any of it.
That's it. I'm calling the cops.
Hold up! Straw. Is this yours?
See your mom around.
I know. Why you think I'm here?
Boy, this cat sure has turned some heads in its time, huh?
Yeah, I guess you're where I'm going.
Where might that be?
I heard about some work down Chickasha Way.
Going alone? Or with your pipe fitter buddies?
Well, I figured me and the boys knock over a couple dozen armored trucks, maybe rob a bank or two.
Listen, Tim, about the wallet.
Hey, catch that vicious pickpocket? Where is he now? Death row?
They found it after you left. The job's still there if you want it.
Yeah? Well, I don't.
So maybe some of this has been my doing. I saw the way my brothers looked up to you. So it is hanging on every word you say.
Can't say I fault their taste.
What I'm trying to say is maybe I'm a little jealous, okay?
Well, your worries are over, pal. Because as of tomorrow, I'm history.
Oh, you think Runoff's gonna change things?
What do you get off lecturing me, Curtis? Seems to me I remember a time Runoff looked pretty damn good to you.
Oh, come on, man. That was years ago.
Oh, was it now? I remember it like it was yesterday. We were 15. Joy riding that borrowed car, you cracked it up and started running.
But you had a sheet. You said, why should I take the fall, huh?
Well, I was wrong. I've been taking that fall ever since, Curtis.
You're never gonna let me forget it, huh?
Ain't nothing to forget. Right there, behind your eyes.
Going. Let me tag along.
And what do you got, rocks in your head?
No, man, I won't be a problem, honest.
Forget it, man.
You need a guy like me looking after you, Tim.
A guy like you, man? You can't even take care of yourself. Quit a good job over at Buck's for chicken feed.
Yeah, but you said, Tim, that...
Forget what I said, man. What your brother says. What Derry says, man, that's what goes.
Derry's living a sucker's world, and you know it.
Man, don't ever talk down to your family, you hear me? Never! Because that's all you got, man. I want you to go back to Buck's, and I want you to say you're sorry. And I want you to get your old job back. And I want you to work your ass off. Okay? Because if I hear different, I swear to God, I'll come back here and personally whip the tar out of you. Is that clear? Runs like a jewel, man.
Short of help.
Yeah. Yeah. Is it my imagination or are those glasses you're wiping?
We're expecting a big crowd tonight. Those boys want to see what they're drinking.
What boys might that be?
Power plant boys. It's their bonus day. Well, every year this time, they get an extra week of pay.
What's their thirst, huh?
Yeah, my tail, too. Best part's the armored truck.
What armored truck?
Well, it goes right out to the plant, pays them in cash. That's how come they come in so flush.
What time's that armored truck pull in?
Beats me.
3, 5, 6, when?
Hell, I don't know. Within the hour, I guess. What's the big hoo-ha, Derry?
Hey, Derry.
Brother didn't pay for his beer.
To get out of my next paycheck.
what?
That I'm here to study your prison pals.
Man, you must have been in the sun too long.
Y'all got a date up at the power plant, right? With an armored truck. Just like you told me, right to my face. You're gonna hit that truck, aren't you?
Get out of here, man.
Aren't you? It's none of your damn business. Son of a bitch coming to my house, joking with my brothers, all that time scheming and waiting for the big score. You put my family at a risk.
You got it wrong, man.
Tell that to Soda. He thinks you're some type of hero.
I tried, man. From day one, I tried.
I went to the mat for you, Shepard. I even got down on my knees to bet him.
What you did on your own, man.
You owe me, Derry. I owe you nothing, Jack. No more. That's it.
You owe me, Derry. You'll always owe me, man.
Shut it down, Shepard. I always heard patience is a virtue. Never believed it till now. You're going back to the slammer, Shepard. Back where you belong. Now turn around.
Turn around. You're under arrest, Shepard. The public rolling. Got it?
You got it?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Like you always said, Jerry, patience is a virtue.
Get down here.
Parole and all, Judge Malden gave him two choices. Get a job or go back to jail. He got a job, all right, at the same power plant he was gonna rob. Maybe a heat wave isn't so bad after all. It pushes people to their limit, some for better and some for worse. For the better, it's just a freak of nature. For the worse, it's only more of the same.
So don't you mess around with me.
Later tonight, Bart declares war on the local bully and finds out the bigger they are, the harder they punch. On a hilarious episode of The Simpsons. And Wednesday, Fox Night at the Movies presents Earth Girls Are Easy with Gina Davis, Jeff Goldblum, and MTV's Julie Brown. Now, stay tuned for America's Most Wanted next.